Hi, this is Mesh Rundown. If you enjoy watching movies as much as we do, subscribe and hit the like button down below.
Today we're going to be doing our movie review on The Witches, the 2021. The Witches is directed by Robert Zemeckis. It stars Anne Hathaway as the Grand High Witch, Octavia Spencer as the Grandmother, Stanley Tucci as Mr. Stringer, Jazia Bruno as the Hero Boy, and Chris Rock narrates it.
The Witches is a classic Roald Dahl tale about a boy who gets turned into a mouse by witches, and he struggles to actually overcome this and fight off the witches in the end.
It's also a remake of the old 1990 movie under the same name, and being a remake based on a book, there's many areas where all three differ from each other. And we'll say the book's the source material, the book's the most important one, the book's where we judge everything off of. And I think the movie in general did a very good job. I thought Anne Hathaway stole the show. There's, I think, a good reason why she was front and center on all the posters, on everything. It's very much focused on her. Her accent was slightly off-putting, but I suppose it was supposed to be very off-putting.
Yeah.
She carries sinister very well. I enjoyed that. I know a lot of people didn't like the fact that she wasn't as ugly and nasty looking as the one from the 1990 version. But I thought she brought a more predatory version of the character to life. And she really looked like she wanted to eat the kid. So I thought she did a very good job.
I think the movie was, in essence, what a Roald Dahl movie should be like. It's exactly what I expected for Roald Dahl. Anne Hathaway was a little bit over the top in her acting, and a lot of the other characters were, but especially Anne Hathaway. And I think that's exactly what makes it a classic Roald Dahl movie, because his stuff is a little over the top.
Yes. It's always a little twisted in a familiar way. It's like the known is scary. It's not this far out beastie creature. It's a witch that's right there. I thought they did a better job with the grandmother and grandson's relationship in this one. They were very close, they were very much together. They didn't focus a lot on that in the original movie. There was very, almost a rushed relationship between them. But this was the beginning to the accident scene, him growing up, getting to grips with his new situation was very touching, it was very nice, it was very well done.
I thought their relationship was very enduring. You could see that there was some closeness, which kind of makes sense because, you know, if that closeness wasn't there and the trust wasn't there, maybe she wouldn't have believed him.
Yes.
After he gets turned. So there's definitely that level of connection between the two of them, of utmost trust, love, respect.
Not to say the original didn't have that, but I think they captured it better in this movie.
Plus, the actress who portrayed the grandmother is...
She's phenomenal.
Yeah, absolutely superb.
The reason why she's won an Academy Award. Like, she can act. Hero Boy, the kid, he's a great voice actor. He really is a great voice actor. He seemed a bit uncomfortable at times, maybe, when he wasn't voice acting, when he was just acting. But voice acting, he's great.
I didn't think there was anything wrong with him while he was acting as much as like you did. I think he did well overall. I think everyone did really well overall. The dynamics were spot on. If I had sat down and not known it was a Roald Dahl movie, I would definitely have gotten Roald Dahl vibes.
I think it was a bit more colourful. It was a bit more warmer, the colours, than I would normally associate with a Roald Dahl book. I would like the colours to be bright and vibrant, but also a bit out of place kind of feel, if that makes sense.
But I think the warm and bright colours that the witches wore did make it out of place. Mm-hmm. Because you'd expect it to be drab and dreary, but it wasn't. And I think that's exactly what made it so much more interesting. And it played much more to our current times. So it made it a lot more relevant because people care about their looks. People care about the colours and fashion. If we had taken it back to then and kept it to the drab and dreary, then maybe they wouldn't have been in place in such a fancy hotel.
Yeah. So I think that brings us to the special effects. And I thought the special effects were very cool. Her arms were a bit weird at times, but I think it was supposed to look a bit jarring. the little masses were done so well. They were cute, they were believable, they were emotive, so it was all in CGI.
I don't know about all in CGI. But the one stage when they were running across the ledge, do you think that was all CGI?
No,
okay, because it looked pretty good.
It looked very good. It was totally believable. And I think that's also where a lot of people's complaints came in about this movie compared to the old one. This old one used a mixture between puppets and real mice. And this is where the nostalgia comes in for a lot of people, I think, because the original one was Jim Henson, who does the Muppets and all that. People love Jim Henson, and rightly so. Jim Henson was a creative genius, but just because it's not the puppets anymore, just because it's not his touch to it anymore, doesn't mean it's not good anymore. So I think that nostalgia of Jim Henson worked on it, Jim Henson brought these puppets to life, brought the stuff to life. Maybe it's not even overt. Maybe people looked at it and went, oh, I remember the puppets, I remember Jim Henson. Now I'm sad that this is different.
I never watched the puppets or anything, so it means nothing to me. So I missed nothing.
I think puppets would have been weird. It would not have felt in place in the movie, which in 1990, yeah, it worked. Now, modern audiences would look out of place, unfortunately.
Yeah, I also think so. The only criticism I'll have against the special effects is that Cat was not always that well done. I think that's where they let down the special effects. Everywhere else was pretty good.
Yes. No, the movie was visually very impressive.
So that brings us into the bad.
Yes. I think a lot of the other witches didn't get a lot of screen time, a lot of anything. They were very much there in the background, not a threat. Even our first introduction to witches, instead of, like in the original book and in the story, Luke meets the witch while he's trapped in the treehouse, basically. In this one, he's in a general store, and she's very much menacing. Like, she's not exactly subtle about anything. It's run away from the witch, as opposed to perhaps get lured into the witch, take the candy. No, there was no way the kid was taking candy from that lady.
No.
She was creepy. And that was the only other witch, really, that was in the movie.
Well, the other witches were there. I think they got more airtime when they were rats.
Turning into rats.
It was quite fun.
Yes, that was fun. Also straight from the original film there, where the heart witch didn't get turned into a rat at the dinner table. They actually had a final confrontation with her, which I think that was also quite well done. I liked the final confrontation. You don't really want the big bad to be taken care of with the little bads. You want a separate showdown. So I liked that.
It felt like they changed the money-making machine a little bit as well, because instead of it being a machine, it just looked like a bag for the money.
Yeah, that was just a bag for the money.
Not that it's necessarily a bad thing.
No. Another thing I didn't quite like, surprisingly wasn't a big fan of Chris Rock's narration. There seemed such a gulf between the kid and his work and Chris Rock. And I understand his age, that he's gone through a lot to get to that point, but it just wasn't working as well for me. I like Chris Rock, and I think he's a good narrator, and he did a good job, just didn't work 100% for me.
I disagree, I loved it. I liked Chris Rock's narration, and Chris Rock has a way to pull you in, so when he started narrating right in the beginning, I was already very into what was happening.
It was very over the top.
But that's Roald Dahl. Roald Dahl is over the top. He's not subtle. When I go watch a Roald Dahl movie, I expect a little over the top.
Yes.
And if that over the topness wasn't there, then it wouldn't have been Roald Dahl for me.
I agree.
So I think it was exactly what a Roald Dahl movie should be. Everything about it was exactly what it should be. So this is a little bit more of a spoiler part. So if you're not interested in listening and you want to watch the movie first, just skip this part.
The book, the movie, and then this movie, they all ended very differently. The 1990 movie ended with the kid getting turned back into a kid. A good witch comes past and saves him, type of thing. And it's a nice feel-good end to a movie, that.
Which was common in the 90s.
Yes, the 90s were very feel-good movies. The book ends with him staying a mouse, and like I think it's the last paragraph or the last sentence is him asking, how long do mice live? And that, good, I wouldn't want to live longer than you, Grandma. Mm-hmm. And that, a horrible way to end it, in general. Like, that would have been a harsh end. It's mean. It is, it's scary. It's like, no.
Well, we're going to die sometime, and you don't know, we could die tomorrow for all we know.
Yeah, but so, like, it's a kid's movie and have a little... Even the glass elevator at the end of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, it sprung up into space. No guarantee you survive in a glass elevator, spring it up into space, but hey, there's a bit of hope that this ends on you're going to die in 3 years.
No.
Your future's gone.
Well, the future he imagined is gone, yes. But he has a new future, and he's got friends, he's got food, he's got family.
In the book, there's no... Bruno doesn't come home with him. Bruno goes on his own way. There is no secondary mouse that's his friend. So he's literally a mouse by himself with his grandmother, but that's it.
So the movie had a nice end.
So I think the new movie stayed truer to the book, but then went a little bit further on, where he now has two friends with him. He's traveling around with his grandmother. He's got a purpose, and they're trying to stop witches. So it felt a bit more uplifting than ending on, you're gonna die.
But that is Roald Dahl, because he stays a lot more true to the Grimm books, because the Grimm, original Grimm stories, like Sleeping Beauty and stuff like that, that we know now, ended not as well as what the newer versions end. So they weren't necessarily happy endings, because they were supposed to teach people morals and the fact that life isn't all rosy all the time and things don't always end well all the time. And, you know, that is life. But now we've twisted all these stories to make them always these happy endings, giving children this belief that no matter what happens, everything's going to be okay. But in reality, that's not true. Sad reality, but reality nonetheless.
How many morals can you remember from this movie?
Don't take candies from strangers.
Always wear your safety belts.
Oh yeah, that was so sad.
Very sad.
But yes, always wear your safety belt. Don't take candies from strangers. Family and friends are very important.
Don't be a glutton.
Yeah.
Don't talk to strangers.
Yeah. Trust people close to you, but also be wary of those people you don't know.
Yeah. Like all the classic morals of like... Just worked into it, and not subtly.
Yeah, subtly but not subtly at the same time. Yes. So to sum up, I think there's a lot of important lessons that they discussed in the movie that maybe we should be reminded about.
And in general, it was just a really fun, good, wholesome movie.
I would give it a solid 8 out of 10.
Wow. I would give it a 7 out of 10.
So the combined score would be a 7.5 out of 10, so that's pretty good.
That's pretty good. It's not too shabby.
Yeah, so we both liked it.
Yes. So if you've seen them both, let us know in the comments down below if you preferred the original or the remake.
Bye.
Later.